Welcome to a short training video designed to introduce you to the different tools and features found in Google Earth. These training videos are designed to assist you in creating and presenting your information to others in a geographic context. This video is part 4 in a series where you'll be learning to create polygons to represent features within your project. There are a couple of different ways to add polygons to your project. The first is to use the drop-down menus at the top of the screen, where you can select Add and Polygons. You can also add a polygon using the toolbar at the top of the screen and selecting the Add Polygon icon. Additionally, you can add polygons directly into the My Places window by right-clicking within the window and selecting Add Polygons. With any of these methods, a dialog box will appear allowing you to name the polygon and provide any descriptive data that you wish to include. This dialog box is also the area where you can use HTML tags to format your pop-up balloons to include links, formatted text, pictures, and videos. For this tutorial, I've gone ahead and created an additional folder to store and organize lakes within my project. For more information on creating folders such as these, please refer to part 2 in this series. I'm now going to add a polygon representing the lower reservoir at Bell's Canyon. I first want to navigate in for a closer view using the navigation controls discussed in part 1 of this series. Once I have found a view I am satisfied with, I'll go ahead and add a polygon using one of the methods previously mentioned. This polygon will be called Lower Bell's Canyon Reservoir, and in the descriptive window, I can provide any additional information for this location that I'd like to present to the viewer, as well as HTML tags to customize the formatting of the information window. I'm now ready to draw a polygon depicting this feature. Drawing within Google Earth is a very simple process and only requires the use of your mouse. To place a point on the map, use the left mouse button, and to delete the previous point, use the right mouse button. A good cartographic rule for curves is that the more points you add, the better the curves will look. Also, if you have a steady hand, you can hold the left mouse button down and draw the feature freehand. Once you've finished drawing the feature within Google Earth, you are ready to format the shape for your project. Because this feature represents a body of water, I can go into the Style and Color tab and change the color to blue. I also want to show some of the satellite imagery through my feature, so I can adjust the transparency to allow the base map to show through as much as I determine. I'll also want a snapshot of view of the polygon that viewers will find more interesting and informative by using the navigation controls, going to View within the dialog box, and selecting Snapshot Current View. Once I'm satisfied with the changes made to the polygon, I'll select OK and the polygon is saved to the My Places folder. I can also move it to different locations and folders within the project by holding down the left mouse button and dragging it to a new location. By following these steps, you can create as many polygons for your project as you like. Anytime you need to go back and revise the information or change the snapshot, simply right-click on the folder and select Get Info if you're running a Mac, and Properties if you're running a PC. This concludes part 4 of this series. To learn about additional features and functions and how to apply them within Google Earth, please refer to the additional tutorial videos found in this series. Thank you for viewing this podcast and for your interest in Google Earth.